video I will demonstrate the concept of topological sorting. So topological sorting is one of the basic graph theory algorithms and it has several applications in real life also. So in this slide I will give an example where topological sorting can be used in practice. So the diagram on the right side is a course prerequisite structure diagram of the University of Miami. So here there are several vertices and each vertex has a number inside it. That number represent the course code of the courses offered by the university. So the edges represent a prerequisite. Suppose that if this course, that is MAD 3305, needs to be studied, then a student has to fulfill the prerequisite of studying MAD 2104. Similarly, if someone has to study MAD 2104, he has to fulfill the requirement of studying MSc 3311, COP 3310 for enrollment. So what topological sorting is doing is, topological sorting will arrange all these vertices in a linear order or in the in a straight order in which each course's prerequisite comes before that course. For example, if in the ordering, in a topological sorted order, if MAD 3512 is there, then this course as well as this one and this one should come before the MAD 3512 comes in the list. Okay, so now comes to the formal definition, that is, a topological sort is an ordering of vertices in a directed acyclic graph such that if there is a path from Vi to Vj, then Vj should appear only after Vi in the ordering. Okay, so if there is a path from Vi to Vj, then all the vertices of Vj should appear, all the vertices in the path of Vi to Vj should appear before we list Vj in the order. Now I have specified a criterion here, that it should be a directed acyclic graph. So why if it is not a acyclic graph? If there are cycles, for example, if there is a cycle like this, so I have shown an arrow from CAP 3700 to MAC 3311, then if this is the situation, then we will not be able to identify where we should start studying the courses. Okay, so if someone has to take this MAC 3311, then he has to fulfill the requirement of CAP 3700 before. So if someone has to study this one, he has to complete this before, and if someone has to study this course, he has to complete MAC 3311 again. So this is the problem with a cyclic graph. In cyclic graph, we cannot apply the topological sorting. So the graph should be directed as well as a cyclic graph. Now, for formalizing the formal algorithm for finding the topological sorted order, then we will be discussing a term in degree quite frequently. So in degree is defined as, in degree of a vertex, V is the number of edges that has this form, that is U, V, which means that if I show an edge U, V, you can say that this edge is ending at the vertex V. So in other words, it actually the number of incoming edges. So if someone asks you what is the in degree of this MAD 2104 node, then that is actually 2, because we have two different edges ending at this node. Similarly, for this node, that is MAC 3311 as well as COP 3210, these nodes does not have or do not have any incoming edges, so n degree of these vertices are 0. Now I will demonstrate a simple algorithm. This is not actually the formal algorithm that we will use for finding the topologically sorted order, but this is a simple algorithm to understand the concept. So the algorithm goes like this. First step, we need to find any vertex with n degree equal to 0. Then we will be finding that vertex, then we'll print that vertex and remove it from the entire graph along with its edges. Then we will repeat the process. If you look at this graph, this V1 is having in degree equal to 0. Okay, so this is the node that we find in this entire graph that has in degree equal to 0. Then what we do is we identify that vertex, then we print that particular vertex. And as the next step, what we have to do is we have to remove this vertex X as well as all of its edges. Okay, so we have a node V1 here, it has three different edges, and we will be removing all these edges as well as this vertex. Okay, so that is done as the next step. Then we will identify if there is any vertex with in degree equal to 0. So we find that V2 has an in degree equal to 0. So as the next step, we will be printing that vertex V2. Then we will remove V2 along with all of its edges. So we are doing it as the next step. We see that if you want to find any vertex with in degree equal to 0, we have to search through the entire vertices to find a node with in degree equal to 0. So here we find V5 is a node which has in degree equal to 0. So what we do is we will be printing that V5 in the topological ordered list. Then we will remove this node as well as its edges. Now if you look at this graph, you will be seeing that if you scan the entire graph, you will be seeing that this particular node has a in degree equal to 0. So we print that vertex, that is V4 is written here. Then we will be removing all the vertices, this vertex and all of its edges. Okay, so that is done as the next step. Now if you scan the entire graph again, you can see that there are two vertices which has in degree equal to 0, that is V3 and V7. So we can use either of these, doesn't matter. So we will be choosing V3. Then we will add this V3 to the list. So we will be writing V3. Now we have to remove V3 and its edges. So we are removing V3 and its edges. Next, we have another node, that is V7 with in degree equal to 0. So we will be writing V7 in the list. So we are writing V7. Now we will be removing V7 and its edges. So we removed V7 and its edges. Now we have only one node that is remaining here, which has in degree equal to 0. So we write that V6 in the list. Then we will be removing V6 and all of its edges. Okay. So this is how we write the topologically sorted order of our graph. Now we can see that we can either use V3 or V7. So if you follow V7 before V3, this will be the topologically sorted order, and all other vertices will be having the same position as before except V3 and V7. So this is the case of the topologically sorted order of this particular example, and these are two different orderings. So one disadvantage that we found here is if you want to find a graph, or if you want to find a node which has in degree equal to 0, you have to search through the entire graph so that you will be finding a vertex with in degree equal process. So in this case, if you remove this V1 and its edges, in degrees are changing only for V3, V4 and V2 only, and there is no change for the in degrees of V5, V6 or V7. So if you scan again the entire graph for changes of in degrees, then that will be a time consuming process and that will be quite inefficient. So what we will do is we will remove a vertex, then we will change the in degrees of its adjacent nodes. Then we will be updating only the in degree values, or we will be searching only the in degree values of these vertices, because all other vertex will not have changed its in degrees. So by understanding this concept, we will be formalizing a formal algorithm for finding the topologically sorted order of a given directed acyclic group. Here I have given an algorithm to find the topological sorting of a given graph. So in order to run this algorithm, we need certain data structures or variables to be maintained. One of that is Q, or this is Q is actually a Q data structure that I will be updating at this position Then we have one more variable called counter, and that is to keep track of the number of vertices that we have already visited, and that is also used to update another array called topNum, where topNum is this array. So this is topNum. TopNum is used to hold the positions of each of the vertices in the final topologically sorted list or in the final topological sorted order. And we have one more array called the inDegree. So this is the position we will be utilizing to store the value of the array inDegree. So this is the array inDegree. And I have shown this as a table because we will be updating the values of inDegree after each iteration. Now, we will be giving the index of each of the position with the names of the vertices. So we have the first one v1, v2, v3, v4, v5, v6 and v7. So in order to start this algorithm, we first need to create this inDegree array with the inDegrees of all the vertices of this graph. So if you look at this one, v1 has an inDegree 0 because there is no incoming edges for v1, and v2 has an inDegree of 1, so I am writing that 1, and v3 has inDegree of 2, and v4 has inDegree of 3, and v5 has inDegree 1, and v6 has inDegree 3, and v7 has inDegree 2. So this is the first thing that we need to maintain before we running this algorithm. So now we start iterating through the algorithm. So first we have to create a queue with the number of vertices. So we have the number of vertices of this particular graph equal to 7. So the queue should be able to hold 7 values at a time. So that doesn't make any difference for the representation that I'm drawing here. Next, we need to initialize the variable counter with value 0. Next, what we have to do is we have to enqueue all the vertices which has inDegree equal to 0 into my queue. So that is written here. That is for each vertex v, that is for every vertex v1 through v7. If the inDegree of that vertex equal to 0, then we have to enqueue that vertex into my queue. So you see that v1 has an inDegree equal to 0. So what we'll do is we will be enqueuing that v1 into this queue. That is, the queue has now the element v1, and you can see that there is no other vertex which has inDegree equal to 0. Next, we will be looking at this while loop. So this while loop is running as long as the queue is not empty. So in our case, the value of q, or the queue, has only one element now, that is v1. So the queue is not empty. So next we need to do is we have to dequeue the queue. That is, we'll be dequeuing this queue. Then whatever is dequeued, then that will be assigned to this vertex or this variable v. So we'll be dequeuing this queue. So in v, we will have the vertex v1 now, because we are dequeuing this queue. So this v will be getting the value v1. So now our queue will be empty. So once the queue is dequeued, we will not have this element anymore. So next, what we are doing is we are incrementing the counter to 1. Then we are assigning that value into the top number of v. So we will be incrementing this value from 0 to 1. Then this 1 will be assigned to a position in this top num vertex where v is equal to v1. So the value of v is now v1. So this particular value will get a number 1. Okay. As the next step, what we have to do is for each w adjacent to v, so how will you find the vertices which are adjacent to v? Because when you look at this graph, which has v2, v3 and v4 are adjacent to the vertex v1, we are not changing the inDegrees of any of other vertices. So what we are doing is we will be subtracting the in degrees of those vertices. So we have vertices v2, v3 and v4 adjacent to v1. So we will be subtracting the in degrees of those vertices only. So first we have v2, so this will be subtracted by 1, that is the meaning of this minus minus in degree of w. So we are subtracting that to v2's in degree to 0. We are subtracting 1, so 1 minus 1 is 0. Then next we have v3. V3 is having in degree 2 now, that will become 1. Then we have v4. V4 has in degree 3, that will become 2. Then the all other in degrees will remain unchanged. Okay. So at the same time, whenever the in degrees of any vertex is becoming 0, we have to enqueue that vertex into my queue. So v2 is the new vertex which has the in degree equal to 0. So we will be enqueuing that particular node into my queue. Now my queue is not empty, so you dequeue the element from the queue, so that is assigned to v. So whenever you dequeue this particular queue, then what you are getting is the value v2. So v2 is the new vertex that we are dequeuing, so this will become v2. Now we'll be incrementing the counter to 2 from 1, so this will become 2. Next we are checking, we will be assigning this 2 to this top num array at the position of v2, so v2 will get a value 2. Now we are checking the adjacent vertices of the vertex v2. So v2 has only adjacent vertices, that is v4 and v5. So we will be subtracting 1 from these vertices, that is v4 and v5. So the in degrees of v4 will become 1, the in degree of v5 will be now 0, and all other values will be unchanged. Okay, now whenever in this process, if any of the newly updated value, that is we have updated value v3 as well as v5, we have updated v4 and v5, if any of this one has an in degree equal to 0, we will be enqueuing that into my queue. So I will enqueue the vertex v5 into my queue. So there is v5 newly in my queue, and there is no other values updated now. Now what we will do is we will be dequeuing this vertex v5 from my queue. So I'm removing v5, then that v5 is taken to the variable v. Then we will increase the position of this counter from 2 to 3, so this will be now 3. Then we will be assigning the number 3 to a position of v5 in this array. So v5 is here, so this will get a value 3. So we will have to find the adjacent vertices of v, that is v is now v5. So v5 has two adjacent vertices, that are v4 and v7. Now we need to subtract 1 from the in degrees of v4 and v7. So v4 has an in degree now 1, so that should become 0. Then v7 has an in degree 2, that will become 1, and all other in degrees are unchanged. Now out of these two in degrees, this v4 has an in degree 0, that has to be enqueued into the queue. So the queue will be having a new value v4. Now this queue is not empty. Now we have to dequeue a value from the queue. So we'll be dequeuing v4, and that v4 will be the new value of v. So I'm writing v4 here. Now I need to increment the value of counter. the counter will get a new value equal to 4. Next, we need to assign this 4 into a position of v4 in this array. That is done through this step. That is, v4 will get a number 4. Next, we have to find the adjacent vertices of v4, then subtract 1 from those in degree values. So v4 has three adjacent vertices, that is v3, v6 and v7. So we are subtracting 1 from first v3, that is 0, then that will be assigned to this queue, so we will do it later. Then we have so we'll do it now again. So this is v3, then we will be having another vertex, that is v6. V6 has in degree 3, that will become 2, and v7 has in degree equal to 1, now that will become 0. So these are the newly updated values. So out of these, 2 are getting the in degree equal to 0, v3 and v7. So we'll be enqueuing that those values, that is v3 and v7 will be there in the queue now. So all other values will be there without any change. So we have v3 and v7. Now we will be dequeuing one of the values from this array. So we will dequeue the first value, because queue is a data structure where which element comes first, that will be taken out first. So we will be dequeuing the value v3 first, and we will write that v3 in the position of v. So this is the value v3. Then we will have to next we will have to increase this counter into 5. So the position of v3 in this array will receive the number 5. So I'll write 5 over here. Next, we will find the adjacent vertices of this vertex, that is v3. So v3 has an adjacent vertex which is v6, and there is no adjacent vertices for v3, and we will have to subtract the in degree of v6 now. So v6 has an in degree 2 now, and we subtract 1 from it, and then it becomes 1. Okay, and that is not 0, so we do not need to enqueue that value into the queue. So we will be writing the values of in degrees of other vertices as before. So these are the numbers. Then you have the value v7 in the queue, then you dequeue that value from the queue. So this queue is dequeued, so we are getting v7 out, and that v7 will be in the order of that v7 is given to the vertex value v. Now we will be incrementing the value of counter into 6. Okay, then we will update the position of v7 in this array to 6. Now we will check the adjacent vertices of this particular vertex, that is v7. So v7 has an adjacent vertex, that is v6, and it does not have any other adjacent vertices. Then so we will update the in degree of that vertex, that is v6, in degree subtracted to 0, and all other vertex will have a value in degree equal to 0. This is actually 0. So whenever it becomes 0, we will be enqueuing that into my queue. So this queue is now having the value v6, and then the queue is not empty. Then if that queue is not empty, then we will have to dequeue that value. So we'll be dequeuing v6, then that v6 will be returned to the variable v. Then we will increment the value of this counter from 6 to 7. Then we will write this number 7 at this position, and you see that v6 does not have any adjacent vertices, because there is no edges originating from v6. So it will not be executing this for loop, Then we are going to check whether the queue is empty or not. Now the queue is empty, so this will be ending the process. Now we are checking one more condition here. If the number of the counter is not equal to number of vertices, so you can see that the counter is having a value 7 and the number of vertices in this graph is also 7. So these two numbers are matching, and these numbers will not match when there are cycles in my. If this is not matching, then the counter will not be equal to the number of vertices. So that gives an indication that there are cycles in my graph. And finally, what you have to do is you have to free the memory that you use. Now you see this ordering, that is V1 up to V7. Then you can see certain numbers written over here. So these number also represent the order in which the numbers are, or the vertices are dequeued from my queue. Or you can also say that this is the order in which we have to write the output sequence. So this order is the order in which we dequeued each of the vertices from my queue. So first we will be writing V1, then we have to write V2, then 3 goes for V5, then next is 4 for V4, then 5 is V3, 6 is V7, and finally 7 is for V6. So this is the topologically ordered sequence, or the topological ordering of this particular. You can see that V1 is having an in-degree 0, that is the first node in this ordering. Then at the end, V6 does not have any edges originating from V6, so that should be the last one. Okay. So this is the algorithm that we demonstrated using this particular sequence, and I hope it is clear for you. Thank you.